Jeff and Tammy Allen only need a few words to sum up the early years of their marriage.
We'd done everything wrong. If there was a way to do it right, we did it wrong every time.
Jeff was a traveling stand-up comic, and Tammy was a waitress in a comedy club when they first met.
He had sworn off waitresses the week before he came to town, and he met me.
Gives you an idea of the kind of discipline I have.
A handful of dates later, Tammy was pregnant. They entered marriage full of hope and expectations.
All I knew, I couldn't hold my parents' marriage up as a example of what a good marriage would be. And so the only examples I had was what I saw on television. When it didn't go that way, it was, of course, a disappointment. You know, people at our wedding were placing bets as to how long it would last. We get asked, is what attracted you to each other? And maybe it was mutual self-loathing. We didn't like ourselves, how could we like each other?
Yeah, we weren't the couple you'd have over for a friendly game of scruples.
Jeff and Tammy moved their new family to Phoenix, Arizona, far away from Tammy's parents. Jeff continued to travel with his comedy career, as much as 250 days a year. And when he was home, he was not the loving husband Tammy had always hoped for.
He would come home from the airport and he'd immediately go to the bills. And he'd go through the roof, you know, just screaming and belittling and making felt small. And I know in his heart, I know today, that he loved us the best that he could. But it wasn't very good.
Jeff's excessive drinking and explosive anger drove their marriage to the brink of divorce and Tammy into the arms of another man.
There was a point that I did the absolute unmentionable. I had an affair. I just wanted somebody to like me. That's all I wanted. I wanted somebody to like me. I wanted somebody to tell me that I was pretty, to sit near me or not have mean things to say.
It wasn't long before Jeff found out about the affair.
I just wanted to tell her I love you. Sorry. Sorry, how does it get here? That was the question I kept asking. How do we get here? How do you go from the hope and the expectations and all that stuff to here?
With their marriage still in ruins, Tammy took the kids to her parents' home for the summer. Jeff was not invited. Left alone to reflect on his broken marriage, Jeff turned his life over to Jesus Christ.
And then when I came home, that's when he announced that he was a born-again Christian. And that's when I turned to him and said, what's that mean?
Jeff was a changed man. His explosive temper cooled and his verbal abuse of Tammy stopped. He became a loving husband and father. Yet as their marriage gained strength, they were hit with another blow. Tammy was diagnosed with cancer. One night, as she went with Jeff to a Gaither concert, Tammy met God for herself.
And they laid hands on me and started praying for me. And it was like the presence, Jesus, God was there. It sounds silly to say that, but I felt him. And when we got back to the room, I said to Jeff, I know this sounds weird, but I know I'm going to be okay. I know I was healed. And at that point, my heart was captured.
We held each other and just praise God. Praise God.
Tammy's salvation and healing brought the couple even closer.
Everything we've been through, there is no earthly reason why we're still married. It is a divine intervention into two people's lives.
We're just not the same people. There's light in his heart. There's light in my heart. We're not self-loathing every day like we were. We know that God loves us, and we know that Jesus died for all the horrible things that I did. I know he did.
So when I read about love and grace and forgiveness, I had a wife who showed me love, grace, and forgiveness. It still boggles my mind. And I thank God thank God for intervening in my life and showing me what love, grace, and forgiveness looks like.